Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I have a new video which is centered around some new products. So if you're eager to see what, then just stay around and I'll get straight to it. So before I begin, I'd like to thank Arteza for sponsoring this video. They very kindly and generously sent me a huge set of gouache paints and a watercolor set. The set is a 36 pan, half pan set, and it came with a water brush. So that's what I will be reviewing in today's video. So in this video, I've just tried to test out the colors. I removed the wrappers. Of course, with any new colors, it's the best part is opening the wrappers and getting the colors all neatly organized. So I did a swatch test first, and they blended pretty well. The colors dispersed well, and the techniques that I normally use are lifting and granulation, and those were the things that I was trying to see these colors, test them out for their transparency, for the lifting capability, and for the most part I was really impressed. So as you can see, I really didn't swatch all 36 colors. I just took a couple of them, the ones that I thought I would, usually the ones that I reach for are the earth colors and of course my favorite pinks. So I just tested out those colors first, and then once I was done with those colors, I decided to just play around with some brush strokes, and did not really have a composition in mind. I just thought I'll just play around and see how these work. But the one thing that I'd like to say here is I had requested they do have 100% cotton paper available as a pad, and I think because of miscommunication I did not get that. So I have used Ashes 100% cotton paper here, and I think that is very, very important, because the way pigments and paints play and work on good cotton paper is not the same on the other cellulose based papers. So keep that in mind when you try any new paints. The one that I'm doing today is 100% cotton cold press watercolor paper. So as you can see here, I started to just play around with some brush strokes, and one thing that I did notice, I did look on the box too, but there was not much, no information, in fact, no information at all about the light fastness, the ratings. So if that is of any concern to you, then as it is for me, because if you are going to be selling your art like I do, I wouldn't want to use something that would fade on my client pretty soon. So that is very, very important, and it's in fact most important thing for me whenever I use pigments or paints, when it is a professional work, when I'm going to be selling my art, I always look for pigments that have good color fastness, and they don't fade. So that is some very key information that seems to be missing with the set. But I don't know if that is because these are not termed professional, they are just called 36 premium paints. So I'm not sure if that is why they are not giving that information. But but when it came to transparency and when it came to the quality of pigments, they were pretty much close to the professional paints that I have. So they were pretty transparent, and they were not as chalky as the student grade paints. Also, they seem to be mid-grade, not student, not professional, something in between, which is a good starter set for most people if you don't want to invest in professional paints. So that is just an opinion, that's just an observation that I felt that I needed to share with you all. If you are very, very sure that you want something which is light, which has light fast ratings, then this one does not have that. So I started with some wet on dry techniques. So I just took my brush to paper. Paper was dry, and I just wanted to see how it would lay on paper, how it would absorb on paper. And then I went back with a wet brush and tried to wash it away, and I was trying to see how well it washed and blended. So that's the first thing that I did. Then after I had finished with the pink and the yellow flower, and then I moved on to a wet on wet technique, where I just went with my damp brush and just put down some strokes and went back and added pigment to it and wanted to see how well it dispersed. So that is how I've been trying different techniques. And then I moved on to see the other colors in terms of the greens. And I really, really love the greens. I think they're by far, so far, they're my favorite. The greens are just amazing. I love it. Usually, I don't go for pre-mixed greens. If you have observed, I usually mix my greens right there on paper. And these greens are really amazing. I love them. So as I started to paint and I realized that there was a composition coming out of this whole thing, I decided to play with it and go with the flow. And I tried to add some more darks to it and I tried to bring some flowers to life by doing some negative painting around it. And if you see the bottom part where you see the blue green, the lower bottom part, you'd see that I did sprinkle some table salt there. And that is because I really love the granulation that happens when you sprinkle salt, and that is a technique that I use often for backgrounds. And I really wanted to see how well these paints would work for that technique. So that is what you see me doing there with the salt. So here I started to mix colors and see how well they blend with each other, because sometimes lower grade paints, they don't really mix so well, and that is one of the reasons I usually never mix my colors on the palette. I always mix them on paper. But here these two blended very well. Here I've used a darker brown with the green, and they gave me a beautiful darker value of green. So I think those greens are going to be my favorite. So here I'm just testing out their darkest darks, that would be the deepest of their blues that they have, and I'm trying to do some negative painting around the flowers just to see them come to life a bit. And I'm just adding the final touches to this. I never really started to make a painting out of this, but I think it looks reasonably good. What do you say? This is how I test out my colors, and I start with swatches, and then I try out different brush strokes and I try different techniques. That usually gives me a good overview of new colors or new pigments that I buy. And one other thing is there's one more clarity that is needed with from artists. I need to ask them, and that is about their pure pigments. I don't really know how many of these are pure pigments and how many of them the rest of them might be convenience colors, and that is something I think we need some more clarity. But for the most part, I think I really love them. So, and that's truly my honest opinion. As you can see, I did this in front of you. So if you are in the market and you're looking for something, I'm sure you could give this one a try. These are moderately priced, and those were my final thoughts on Arteza watercolors. And pretty soon I'll be back with a video, and I will be doing a review on their gouache paints. See you soon then. Bye bye. Thanks for joining me.